Ready to begin a new chapter. The chapter is called Electrochemistry. Electrochemistry chapter is a wonderful chapter to bring in concepts from so many different places that we learned throughout the semester. So the geek in me really likes the electrochemistry chapter. What electrochemistry really does is it deals with the interface between chemical reactions and obtaining electrical energy from those reactions. So we have an electric car here. Now, whether or not you have a chemical reaction occur that gives you electricity, that's one way, or you can pump electricity in order to force the reaction in reverse, and that would be, of course, charging your batteries. So we've got both that we'll look at. We'll look at, I'll bring us up this thing. So here's the definition, the formal definition of electrochemistry. It's a branch of chemistry that deals with the interconversion between electrical energy and chemical energy. So we know chemical energy is the energy stored within the bonds, and electrical energy is the flowing of electrons through, let's say, a wire. So we're going to first focus on this aspect, the energy being released when a reaction occurs spontaneously. Now, it has to be a very specific type of reaction. It has to be an oxidation-reduction reaction. An oxidation-reduction reaction is called a redox reaction for short. So that is one set of reactions that we're going to look at. Then we're going to take it to the next level, which is the reverse. And we won't spend as much time on this one, but if you push in electrical energy, you can force a non-spontaneous reaction to occur. Batteries work by having a spontaneous chemical reaction inside of them that generates electricity. You can charge some batteries by pumping that energy back in, pushing it in, and forcing the reaction in its reverse. So, like I said, redox is a short name for oxidation reduction, and in every case, it is a transfer of electrons. So something is gaining electrons, something is losing electrons, they're going from one substance to another when a redox reaction occurs. Not all reactions are redox reactions. It has to have that transfer process. Now, I have a mnemonic that I remember to know which is happening for oxidation and reduction, and mine is Leo says grr. Since Leo's a lion and he growls, it works for me. Loss of electrons is oxidation, gain of electrons is reduction. You cannot have an oxidation without its paired reduction. You can't lose electrons unless there's something to gain them. You can't gain electrons unless there's something there to lose them. Okay, so let's look at this very simple reaction here. To know whether or not something is gaining or losing electrons, you need to be able to determine their oxidation numbers. Now, that's something that we have learned in the past, what oxidation numbers are, so I want to just have this as a review for you. I have sodium, the solid, the metal, on the left-hand side of this equation, and for sodium, I want to know what is its oxidation number? What is its charge? Okay, so an oxidation number is a charge it would have if it became an ion. What is its charge? Well, hopefully you said zero. And I trip up a lot of students. When they find out that it's zero, they get a little shocked by that notion. But one of the first rules for determining oxidation numbers is that elements in their stable form, you take an element and it's always going to have an oxidation number of zero. So I'm writing this reaction, and before we can go any further here, we're going to do the oxidation numbers of everything. So sodium is the elemental sodium. If it was just Na and it had a charge, we would have to have a charge written right there. So we know it has no charge. Here is elemental chlorine, chlorine gas, so it has no charge. And then we have the ionic compound. In the ionic compound, it is going to have charges other than zero. So if you look at a periodic table, you can quickly see that those are their charges, so those are their oxidation states. So now we've kind of followed along for this reaction showing those oxidation states. So now we can make a judgment as to what substance is oxidized. Now, Leo says grr. Let's see if you can find the right answer. Well, did you pick that Sodium was oxidized. Oops, I don't have a check mark there. Sodium goes from 0 to plus 1. How do you go from 0 to plus 1? We had to have our electron pulled off. This guy lost an electron. So sodium has a loss of the electron, so it is oxidized. And you cannot have something oxidized unless you have something else reduced. And the chlorine gained that electron, and so the chlorine is reduced. Okay, so that is something we have covered in the past and just need to refresh our memory of the terms that go along with that. Now, this redox reaction was balanced as soon as it got its elements balanced, but that's not always the case. What we're going to learn next is how to balance redox reactions. And it's not always just as simple as making sure you have the right coefficients so that the elements are balanced. So we'll look at a very detailed procedure next.